गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, होप यू ऑल आर फाइन। इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो लेक्चर आई टॉट यू अबाउट द इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ द चैप्टर नंबर 2। नाउ टुडे आई एम जस्ट मूविंग फॉरवर्ड एंड एक्सप्लेनिंग दैट चैप्टर एंड चैप्टर नंबर 2 विल कंटिन्यू टुडे ऑल्सो। इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर आई टॉट यू अबाउट दैट हाउ प्रोपोजिशंस वर्क्स ऑन। Now to work on with these propositions, we have some operators by which we can only do our work. So in today's lecture, I will teach you all that what are these operators and how these operators works on. Okay? It is better that you please hold your book in your hand also, then you will more clear whatever I say. Okay, so let us start our today's video lecture with the topic operators. Okay, it is operators are also known as connective. Why this name is given? Connective means it is used to join. It is used to join. Operators are basically performed on compound statements, because here more than one simple propositions are there, and will perform this plus and implication, biconditional and negation operators to perform the different situations. Now let us understand that what these particular signs are, like plus and implication, then biconditional and then negation. What are the uses of these operators? How they are implied in any situation? So the first one is disjunctive. The other name for disjunctive is or. So it can be called as disjunctive operator, or we can say or operator. For this we are having two symbols, one is plus and plus, next one is V sign or sign. If we can take it as a alphabetical name, then it is the sign V, but in terms of computer it is known as or operator. So don't be confused about it. Now this operator says, what is the situation? Situation is this, that if P is true, or we can say if Q is true, make it more simple, if any of the condition is true, then we'll get a true value. I will give you the truth table also in the next video lecture of this particular operators, but first of all let us understand with only the words. Disjunctive says if any of the condition is true, then we'll get a true value. That means if India plays well, then it will be win for India. If I say if India plays well, here one condition is there, plays well, then only it win. That means the condition totally depends on the first one. So here we cannot say that it is a disjunctive one. We have to make situations like that, that it gives you two separate situations. Like if I'll give you one example for disjunctive, then take it. If I am having money, in my pocket. If I am having money in my pocket. Or, I am talking about or. If I am having money in my pocket or if I am having money in my wallet. Wallet means I am talking about the different networking wallets like phone pay wallet, Google Pay wallet, Paytm wallet. If I am having money in my wallet, if I am having money in my pocket or if I am having money in my wallet, in this situation I will come to the party. In this situation I will come to the party. Make it more clear. If I am having money in my pocket or if I am having money in my wallet, then only I can come to the party. So that means if any of the situation will true, then I will come. Okay? If there is no money in my wallet and money is in my pocket, then also I can go. If there is no money in my pocket and there is money in my wallet, then also I can. If both condition will true, then also I will go. But if money is in not pocket and if money is not in wallet, in that condition I cannot go to the party. Okay, so here we can say in disjunctive one both conditions have to be false. In that case only we cannot go. The reverse situation for conjunctive, and I have given you the example also. In this one what happened? Both condition have to be true, then only we'll get a true warning, otherwise we'll get a false one. Suppose the same example I take and I put in place of or I put and, then what happens? See, if money is in my pocket and money is in my wallet, then only I can go to the party. If money is in my pocket and if money is in my wallet, then only I can go to the party. That means both conditions have to be true to go to the party. I hope you all are clear. Now the next one is conditional operator. In conditional operator, the sign is, in conjunctive, the two signs are there. The first one is and symbol and the next one is reverse V symbol. Reverse V symbol. Okay. Now, the next one is conditional. In conditional, there is two ways. There is two ways to represent conditional statement. The first one is if then, and the second one is implication. The name for this, three names are there. The first one is conditional, second one is if then, and the third one is implication. Clear? And these are the three symbols. The first one, simple implication. The second one, a dash and implication. And the third one is a situation. And here we can say if P then Q. Its meaning, if P is true, that means in this situation we can say if P is true, then only Q is true. If P is true, then Q is true. This is the situation for conditional statement. Next one is biconditional. If and only if. If and only if. And the second name is equivalence. So the two names for biconditional is if and only if and equivalence. Two names are there and these are the two symbols. The first one is this one and the third one is this one. So three straight lines makes a symbol of biconditional. Okay. In biconditional, what happens? Biconditional says if and only if P is true, then Q is true. Its meaning is P and Q are either both true or false. Well, that means if and only if P is true, then only Q is true. Here in conditional one, there is not this situation. Here it says if P is true, then Q is true. But here it says if and only if. If and only if, that means P must have to be true, then only Q will be true. Okay. So keep this in mind. Now the last one is negation. Negation says whatever the situation is, whatever the condition is, doesn't matter. If P is true, that means negation of this, that means P is false. That means if I say you have to do this work and you used negation operator over there, then that means you will not do that work. Clear? I hope you all are clear about it. So let us revise it. Disjunctive means if any of the condition is true, then we'll get a true value. Both condition will false, then only we'll get a false value. In conjunctive, if any of the condition is false, then we'll get a false value. If both condition is true, then only we'll get a true value. In conditional operator, if then, that means if P is true, then Q is true. If P is true, then Q is true. Now you don't be get confused about P and Q. P and Q are the two situations which I have taken. That means I am just assuming that there is two sentence P and Q. In biconditional, if and only if, that means if and only if P is true, then only Q is true. Okay. And the last one, negation, that means the reverse condition, opposite of that situation. Okay. Hope you all understood it. If you have any problem, you just go through the video one or two times, then you'll get a solution for it. Okay. Bye. Have a nice day.